This is the second video about the topic logarithms, and we are going to discuss here few of the questions, and side by side we will brush up their properties as well. Okay, so the first question is, prove the following. Okay, the question first is, a x is equivalent to 1 over, we have to prove this, log of w over z to the base y. Okay, given that w raised to the power x is equivalent to yz raised to the power x. This is given. So we have to start from here and we will go here. Okay. Now if you see in this part what is given to us, there is nothing given like what that is called log, but here everything is given, something is there with log. Okay. So let's start. W raised to the power x is equivalent to yz raised to the power x. The first thing you have to do, taking log on both sides. So it will be log w raised to the power x is equivalent to log of yz to the power x. Okay. Then next thing what you have to do is log of w raised to the power x. So we can apply the log property. X log w is equivalent to, here we have two terms in multiplication. Okay, so I will split that first. This is not log yz to the power x, it is just z to the power x. Okay, so we cannot apply the power property first. So log of y plus log of z raised to the power x. Okay, and then what is given? X log w is equivalent to log of y plus this x I will bring in the front using the rules. You have to write all the rules here in the side. Okay. Now we have to prove x equal to. So basically what we do, we will collect all the terms containing x on one side. So it is x log w minus x log z is equivalent to log of y. So here x I can take common from these two. So I will get x log w minus log of z in bracket is equivalent to log of y. Okay. Now if you see, what is this log a minus log b? So it is log of y over z. See, we are coming to the solution. Is equivalent to log of y. Okay. Now here, take this log of y to the other side. Okay, so log of y over z over log of y is equivalent to 1 by x. I did cross multiplication. I took this x here and bring this log y in the denominator here. Okay, so now what is this? This is log a over log b, and I told you one property related to this, that if you have log of a over log of b, this is equals to log a by b. Okay, so from here what we were getting, log of y over z to the power log y. So I mean we have log of y over z to the base y, and that is equivalent to 1 over x. So what will be x? Just flip it. So flip it, it will become x. And if you flip it, it will become log of w over z to the base y. So basically we got one, x is equals to 1 over log y over z, and here is y. This is what we had to prove. Okay. Now next question is also there. Let's try that one now. The question is, you have given w raised to the power 3 minus x, okay, times y raised to the power 5x is equivalent to w x plus 5 and y raised to the power 3x. And we have to prove that x log y over w is equivalent to log w. Let's start this. Again, we have given this thing and we have to reach a solution where there is a log. Okay, so what we can do over here, quite simple. First of all, taking log on both sides. So log of w raised to the power 3 minus x and y raised to the power 5x is equivalent to log of w raised to the power x plus 5 and y raised to the power 3x. Now the two things are in product here and here. So apply the same rules, log ab is equal to log a plus b. So 3 minus x plus log of y 5x. Okay, is equivalent to log of w x plus 5 and plus log of y raised to the power 3x. Now bring, use the power rule. So that means log of a to the power b is a log b. So 3 minus x log w plus 5x log y is equal to x plus 5 log w and then 5x, sorry, then 3x log y. Okay, now what you can do here, if you see here, one side we have x log y w. Okay, that means we have to find x common. So first of all, I open it. So what I'm gonna get it, 3 log w minus x log w plus 5x log y, and here is x log w plus 5 log w plus 3x log y. Okay, so now what we can do, we can take all the terms first on one side just to solve it. Here is 3 log w and here is 5 log w. If I am taking the terms on this side, so it will become 2 log w. Okay, here is x log w, here is minus x log w. When this will go to other side, it will become 2x log w. And here is 3x log y, here is 5x log y. So basically when this 5x thingy will come to here, it will become minus 2x log y. Okay. Now what we are gonna get is, we have here 2 log w, but here we have similar terms, 2x and 2x here, but here is log w and log y. Okay. So how we can solve it now? So I'm gonna write this same. Let me see what we got here. 2 log w, 2 log w plus 2x log w okay, and then we got minus 2x log y okay, minus 2x log y. Now here 2 is everywhere, so it is equal to 0, so we can cancel that 2. Okay, we can take it common. It is x log w minus x log y is equal to 0. Now what we have to prove here, if you see, we have to prove we have to prove log y over w and times x. That means something will be log y minus log w. So from here I am getting a hint. Okay, so we got here log w plus x, x is common here, log of w minus log of y is equal to 0. Okay, but we want, from here if I get, I will get log y over log w over y, but we want log y over w. So what I'm gonna do, I will take it to other side. It will become minus x log of w minus log of y, and I will change this sign, this minus will go inside, so it will become positive log y minus log w. Why I am doing this step? Because they have written log y over w, so log a minus b is log a over b. So x, this is log a minus b, this is equivalent to log of w, and this is what we have to prove. Just go step by step. start with general, taking log and all, and then go towards a particular proof, what we have to prove. Sometimes what is written in proof, it will help you a lot to find out what we have to do in the next step. If it is y over w, so that means it should be log y minus log w. From here I come to know, okay, I need to take these two terms to the other side. Okay, now next question is, solve the following equations showing all the working. All right, I'm gonna do one of this question. So it is written e raised to the power x minus e raised to the power minus x, and this is equivalent to 2. So solve means we have to find x value of the variable. So e to the power x as it is, this is e to the power negative, so I'll take it to denominator, and this is equivalent to 2. Here for simplicity, e to the power x, you can consider it is something like y. So it is y minus 1 over y is equivalent to 2. If I solve it, it will become y square minus 1 is equal to 2y. Okay, how you are making the denominators equal. So we got y square minus 2y minus 1 is equivalent to 0. Now this is a quadratic equation and we know how to solve it. First we will find the discriminant, which is b square minus 4ac. Here b value is this. So minus 2 square minus 4 times a is 1 and times c is minus 1. So it is 4 plus 4, 8, which is greater than 0. So we will get two different values of y. So the y values will be minus b. So plus 2, because minus of minus b, plus minus square root of 8 over 2a. A is 1. So we got minus 2, first value will be, two values we are getting here, 2 plus root 8 over 2 and plus 2 minus root 8 over 2. Let us simplify these ones. So one value is 2 plus a root 8, we can write in this way. So this will be, when you will simplify it, you will get something like this. So y is equals to 1 plus root 2. And another value you will get, that is 2 minus 2 root 2 over 2, which is 1 minus root 2. 2 was in common. So we got y is equal to 1 minus root 2. Okay. Now if you simplify this value, that what we got over here, which is value given as 1 minus root 2. So 1 minus square root of 2. This value is equivalent to minus 0.4142. okay, and another value is 1 plus square root of 2, that is equivalent to 2.4142. now what is y? Actually our question is in terms of e, so y is equal to e to the power x. So basically we have to find x. So we got e to the power x is equivalent to minus 0.4142. And another we got e to the power x as 2.4142. Now what you have to take log on both sides. When we have exponential e, so we take ln function, ln function. So ln e to the power x, because we have to find this x. When we have to find the value of power here, we cannot express this in terms of e, we don't know. So what the best thing is, take log on both sides. This is a crucial point. Okay, here you cannot express this decimal value in terms of e to the power, so better take log. Ln e to the power x, and it is e, so it is take ln. And ln 2.4142, here it is x ln e is equal to ln 2.4142. Ln e is always 1, remember this, it is always 1, and this is equivalent to ln 2.4142, which is equivalent to 0.88136, which is like 0.8814. That is the first value. Another is e to the power x is equal to minus 0.4142. Same step you have to do. Ln e to the power x is ln negative 0.4142, which is equivalent to x equal to, so we have to take ln again of the value minus 0.4142. This is not possible, sorry, because we cannot take the log of a negative value. So this is not possible, so you will get only one solution. Okay, thank you.